some of you are asking the Most High for clarity and understanding on hearing him. Sometimes he speaks to you through numbers. Sometimes he speaks to you through music. And sometimes, this is a revelation that he just placed on my spirit, sometimes it'll just be through the chorus of a song, not necessarily the whole song. Many gospel singers have been exposed by being part of Puff Daddy's list of trafficking. So the Most High is revealing many things in this season. And just because they sing gospel does not mean that the song is anointed. So sometimes the Most High will use gospel, but I'm noticing a lot of times he'll use secular music. And it's crazy because you would think that the gospel music would be anointed and everything. But sometimes the gospel music is more wicked than the secular music because of the surroundings of where they recorded, who recorded it, all of that. You have to take all of that into consideration. And it's beautiful that he showed me this. You know, we think just because it's a gospel song that it's anointed. Some of us, I don't, but some of us do. And we have to stop being so closed-minded into thinking that every song that says Jesus or Yahweh or whatever, Elohim, Hosanna, whatever you call him, that is holy. And it's not always the case. This is still a man, or, you know, man meaning man or woman, that's doing a song. And sometimes they ain't right. They heart ain't right. And if they heart ain't right and they're doing a song, it's no different than a secular song, if you want to put it in that context. You know what I'm saying? So be mindful. He wanted me to share that with you guys. Peace and bless. Oh, so he said, yes, that's me talking to you for who this is for. Take it back to him for clarity. But you'll already know. You won't have to go to him for clarity because you're already in this cycle. You have already prayed and asked him for clarity. So this is your clarity, okay? Peace and blessings.